Good morning, everybody. This is Kim Danke coming to you live from the Shibboleth Studios in Kennesaw, Georgia. And today is Tuesday, August 10th, 2021. And we are on day, we have 144 days left in the 2021 edition of the Game of Life. And I hope that you are going to play with me. And you know, there's ups and downs. There's ups and downs in the day, in the Game of Life. There's ups and downs from moment to moment. It can be like riding a roller coaster, but we just have to hang on. When you hop on here this morning, please say hello, just like Larry just did. Tell me where you're from and what type of Shibboleth day you are having. I'm going to have an intermittent fasting day. Any perfect day that I have is typically an intermittent fasting day. And then if by chance I do something late at night and need a little something, I might do that full-filled chicken bouillon that you can get from the Shibby Shop, either in person or online. You can pick that up. But I use that. And then if I do that, I go back and change it. But typically, even then, I could get a 12-hour fast in there. But I like a 16 daily. So that's what I typically do, sometimes a little bit longer, depending. But I'm having an intermittent fasting day, even though I'm going to another luncheon today. Went to a luncheon yesterday, didn't even eat their lunch. They had salad with stuff all over it, broccoli, I didn't want that. They had rice, didn't want that. And they had blackened chicken. I like chicken, but I don't like it blackened, so I didn't want that. And they had a whole bunch of desserts. So I ate my oatmeal protein pie and was satisfied and happy. And today, I'll see what they're having at the luncheon again today. See if I can make myself something perfect. And if I can't, I'll probably eat another oatmeal protein pie. So I am a pound and a half away from my 50-pound badge back. You know, the 50-pound badge for me is kind of hard to keep. That's kind of at my low end, which I don't mind. But that gives me what to strive for. So I'm a pound and a half from that. So I was like, I want to get that. So I'm going to continue to have perfect days and see if I can see that badge for even just a day. Hey, good morning, Melanie. Perfect day in Royston, Georgia. Hey, Jonathan. IMF day for Jonathan. Oh, you're welcome. I'm happy to talk here every day. I love it. I want it to be a time of us focusing on our day. Just today. All we got to do is focus on today. What can we do today to make ourselves just a little bit better than yesterday? Thank you, Jonathan, for that encouragement. Good morning, Michelle. Playing the game of life, and I'm on a roller coaster. Amen, girl. Amen. Yes. Good morning, Lynn. Having a perfect day from Carrollton, Georgia. Kathy from Michigan having a perfect day. Ron is having a perfect day in Lilburn, Georgia. Michelle is having an IMF day in Carrollton, Georgia, even though life is a roller coaster. What she's doing anyway. We let a lot of excuses get into our way, don't we, sometimes? I was talking to some people last night about that very thing. Hey, Marilyn from Michigan, IMF day. Good morning, Polly from Dalton, Georgia, IMF day. Hey, Susie, good morning, Philadelphia, Mississippi. I'm on the roller coaster now. Yes, but you're having an IMF day. Do you know how awesome it is to at least have control over something? You can have control over what you eat. Becky, good morning from Lake City, Florida. IMF day. Hey, Alicia from Fort Oglethorpe. Spartan Elite IMF day. That's a special kind of IMF day because she's doing a challenge with Jason. Perfect day for Becky in Ooltewah, Tennessee. And Christy James, IMF day. Good morning. Good morning. And hey, Jeannie, good morning from Knoxville. Glad you're here with us. We got people from all over the country. I always love that. It's so exciting. We even have Donna Denbach from Canada who's joining us on Saturdays for the online accountability meeting. So we are excited to have her there with us as well. Good morning, Gina. Having a perfect day. Good morning, Tabitha. Perfect day in Pennsylvania. On our way for some hiking. Fun. Fun. And it's going to be easier to hike with that 20 pounds off, Tabitha. We all know that, right? I bet she's laughing right now. So, good morning, Rebecca, IMF day, coming back from a trip. Yes, well, we're glad that you had a trip. Hopefully, it was a good one. And yesterday, I went to a luncheon that was on cybersecurity. I could not have felt more stupid when I left there. I mean, I felt stupid. I felt slightly fearful of all of the people out there trying to take advantage of us There's always someone who is trying to take advantage of us, whether they are criminals or whether they're just people trying to sell us something, you know, that's how they make their living, but they don't care about what type of nutritional situation we're in, and or to find out what type of nutritional situation we're in. They're just going to sell us whatever, you know, like all the noise out there about certain things that you should do. And like buy MCT oil, use it in this, take it as a supplement. We don't do that. If you've got body weight to lose, you use it for three reasons: cooking, in recipes, and to make approved salad dressings. But that was just an example. But have y'all ever been anywhere and you left there and you just felt so stupid? Well, yesterday was one of those days. Now, there were three people on the stage as this panel, and one of which is a friend of mine. It's the director of the Georgia Bureau of Investigations, and he's just the kindest, sweetest man. And the other one was the Attorney General of Georgia, and then the other one was a cybersecurity specialist. Anyway, but I know they didn't mean to make you feel stupid, and I don't think that they did. I think it was just me. You know, you go there and these people are just brilliant. They are just brilliant and so smart. And you can just feel so small because they're just so smart. And then you can also feel like, wow, what they're talking about is really scary. And the fact that there's viruses being sold on the web to infect, you know, small businesses. So there's always something that is coming at us, always. And you know, yesterday was not a fun day. So I left lunch. It was I felt like a dummy when I left lunch, but that's okay. I'm not gonna worry about it. See, things don't keep me down very much. And then I had some distractions yesterday afternoon. I show up at class and there are 10 waiting and wanting people there to learn about Shibboleth. So guess what I had to do? Pull it together in a moment's notice. And I did. And we had a good class. And I couldn't sleep last night either though. So it was one of those days. I know we all have those days. So I've got a great devotion for us this morning. Good morning. Good morning, Georgina from Chatsworth, having a perfect day. Good morning, Christy from Ball Ground, Georgia, having a perfect day. Good morning, Gina, Tammy Roush. This is a good morning Bible study with you. Hey, Tammy, when you listen in. Jonathan, cybersecurity is my jam. It's part of what I do. Yes, there are lots of bad people out there. Be careful. The things they were saying yesterday were so terrifying. And I felt like I was almost at the mercy of these criminals that they're talking about. And it was just, Christy, thank you for saying that about drinking more water last week. It really helped me. I have been getting in my 64 ounces, but not pushing or even trying for more. Your words are very helpful and encouraging. Thank you, Christy. Thank you for telling me that. So I did take my own advice and I started getting in some gallons of water last week, and it really did help me have easier, perfect days. So thank you for confirming that, Christy. I appreciate that. Gina, thank you for sharing. Y'all, look in the left-hand corner of your screen if you're on a device, and you will see the share button. The share button helps us get out into the world. Do you know what I want Shibboleth to be? A household name. You know what's a household name? Keto. Now, not that they're doing it or not doing it, doesn't matter, but they know it. I want Shibboleth to be that because Shibboleth is better, and I want us to share this. So please let that out there. Valerie, good morning from Indiana, having an intermittent fasting day. Hey, Kathy, good morning from Santa Fe, Tennessee. And let's see, Gina says that she has to train for that every 6 months in banking. You are not a dummy. You can learn anything. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I actually think I can learn everything, Gina, so thank you for that. But that was just one of those things where you're sitting there, and it's not just that these people are so smart. It's also that they're talking about a fearful subject. And you're just like, it's like these little barbs are just being shot at you. And I was like, that wasn't a fun lunch. I didn't like that lunch at all. Let's see. Kathy had to take an online course in cybersecurity yesterday. It seems if anyone gets a message that is alarming, it induces fear, it is fake. Wait. It seems if anyone gets a message that is alarming or induces fear, it is fake. And then Monica, Awesome. Monica's asking if that's Chatsworth, Georgia. Her mom lives there and does Shibboleth. Good morning, Karen. Wow Challenge in Michigan. And Polly says that she's had so much stolen from her. I mean, if they get your info, it's so scary. Yes, share Kim with the world. Oh, thank you, Jonathan. Let's share Shibboleth with the world. And let's share Jesus with the world through Shibboleth, however we can to get to them. Ministry. Yes, Polly. And Polly is not stupid or naive, but it still happens. Good morning, Diane, Columbus, Mississippi. IMF day. And Charlene from Michigan, having a perfect day. So, this morning, I'm praying. I didn't do my prayer time yet. I did some Bible reading and some different things this morning. Started reading through Romans, but didn't make it all the way through. Yeah, hashtag 1 million. I love that, Alicia. We need it to be a household name. Good morning, Tony. Good morning. If y'all have, I messaged Tony yesterday. If y'all have a, that we were talking about the Right Now Media. Some of our churches provide it to us. If you've got that, I need you to watch just the first session. Even if you don't want to watch all the rest of the sessions, I need you to watch the first session of Tony Evans's Kingdom Woman. I need you to watch it today. It is extremely inspiring. So I went to that luncheon yesterday. I mean, I was hyped. I was ready to go. This is like the roller coaster, okay? I was hyped. I was like, whoa, what he just said was awesome. I'm ready to go. I'm messaging Tony. Tony, you got to listen to this. This thing is good. And then I go into this luncheon. I have a one-on-one with a lady because I'm going to be moderating a panel at a women's conference that's coming up soon. And so I set up a time to talk with her. I'm talking with her. It's such an interesting story. It's inspiring. And then crash and burn on cybersecurity stuff. Blah. And then I get back into the car and I'm like, let me put that Tony Evans's stuff back on again. That was terrible. And so I put Tony Evans's, he was the one that did the first webinar for their series, but it was not his daughter Priscilla. It was another daughter that was doing it. So I started listening to her, and then all kinds of messages started coming through, and you're like, I had to put it down because I was driving distracted. So I put that down just so I could listen and focus. Y'all, we did a Shibby show recently called Dealing Authoritatively with Distractions. This world is full of them all the time. And I have actually taken the title of that Shibby show several times since we've done that and thought, deal authoritatively with that, Kim. Why are you letting that distract you? Deal authoritatively with that right now. And I have used it several times. And yesterday when I took my phone, I know my way home, you know. I had the phone up there for the GPS, but I didn't use it. It was just sitting up there. And then when all these messages started coming through, I sat that down just so I could focus in and listen on something more positive than that cybersecurity stuff. But anyway, this morning I was like, Lord, what am I going to say? What am I going to say this morning on the Shibby Show? And awesome, Alicia, it really does. Thank you for sharing, Diane. Yes, Tony says she's got to put her phone zipped up in her purse when she drives. Yes, y'all. So I was like, what am I going to say, Lord? And I looked at several things. None of it was like this, say this. But I decided, I wasn't bringing up anything to say, I thought, just go to this devotion that my friend Sonia got for me for Christmas because she knows that I read to y'all. He Holds My Hand by Carol Kent. And I said, you know what? Just simply go to today. Just go to today's devotion. And of course, it was perfect. So it's called Triumph. Triumph. And the little quote for the day is, no matter what problems we face, we already have victory in Christ. Let's give thanks to God and follow Christ who leads us in triumphal procession. And then the verse for today, if y'all want to type that in, is 2 Corinthians 2:14. 2 Corinthians 2:14. But thanks be to God who always leads us in triumph in Christ and manifests through us the sweet aroma of the knowledge of him in every place. Wow, that really goes along with Romans 5 that I was reading this morning too. I love how they all cross-reference each other. Okay, it says, No matter what is happening in your life right now, live in victory. And guess what came up this morning as a memory? My victory badge from 2 years ago. So that's cool. You may be facing problems with your work, your health, your marriage, your children or your grandchildren, or your finances. Despite these struggles, I challenge you to lay hold of my promises. I will meet all your needs according to my glorious riches, Philippians 4:19. When people lie about you and spread hurtful rumors about your character or your actions, remember where your strength comes from. The Lord is with me, and he is my helper. I look in triumph on my enemies. Let me be your defender. Imagine yourself in a triumph. Okay, so this is where I want you to actually do this. I want you to imagine yourself. Imagine yourself in a triumphal procession with me, out in front as your leader. Sometimes you forget that when you face battles in your Christian life, you are not alone. Here is the blueprint for walking in triumph. We use God's mighty weapons, not worldly weapons, to knock down the strongholds of human reasoning and to destroy false arguments. We destroy every proud obstacle that keeps people from knowing God. We capture their rebellious thoughts and teach them to obey Christ. Claim your victory in Christ every day and walk confidently in it. Hey, Rachel, good morning. Thank y'all for typing in the verse. But I want to go back to this. Imagine yourself in a triumphal procession with me out in front as your leader. I'm about to play for you the very beginning of a song by my favorite group musicians, Newsboys. And it's called the Revelation Song. A lot of people sing Revelation Song, but their version is my favorite. I won't be able to play it long because Facebook will send me off because of copyright rules and everything. But I want you to think about that triumphal procession with this as your song. Let me see, make sure I get it loud enough. Make sure I get it loud enough so we can be on a triumphal procession. Okay, I'm gonna cry because that music makes me want to be on a triumphal procession, okay? And that's how I'm going out today, triumphant. And I want y'all to do the same thing. Get that song, their version of it. Pull it up on YouTube. Do whatever you got to do. But that song will make you just be triumphant, okay? And I want that for all of us, and especially in the area of eating and taking care of our body, okay? So go march on the day. Go march on the day triumphantly, okay? Go journal. And as Alicia reminded everybody the other night on that How I Overcame Food Addiction, Lost Weight webinar, that I say, do not pass go. Do not collect $200. You go directly to your journal after this and journal your day. You determine your day. Your day does not determine you, okay? You're triumphant in Jesus. If you don't know Jesus, please let us know. Message me personally. I would love for you to know him. Because life's not perfect and you need somebody to be there with you. And then the other thing, if you are watching on replay, please type in hashtag Shibboleth for his glory. Okay, because that lets me know that you're watching it. And I do appreciate that people watch it. That's right, Becky, put on the full armor of God. Karen, thank you. Thank you, Karen. Polly says, I'm in a royal family, a child of the king. I am his. You know, I always wanted to be a princess. And so I do walk around sometimes with Polly and go, I'm a princess. I'm a princess. You know, it's okay to do that. We need to stay positive and focused on him. So thank you for reminding us of that, Polly. Good morning, Tammy. Tammy, you can find it in Lap 2. She was picking beans. Yes, Tammy in Lap 2. Did I get it up there last night? Yeah, I did. I processed it and got it up there last night. It's in Lap 2 of Fast Track, where it says, watch the 7 nightly webinars. That's just where they're housed, and it leads people to watch that. Now, Fast Track, y'all got to trust Fast Track. It will work. It will work. And yes, Tony says, eat to glorify God. Let me just tell you, this eating thing, it's a bigger deal than people want to make it out to be, and it is one of the absolute best ways to glorify God. So I want us to learn it and apply it daily. That's right. Victory in Jesus. With him, all things are possible. Let's see, Travis, Tony says, like Travis said the other day, if you don't remember why, do it for God. That's right. That's right. And there you go. Alicia just bought up the Newsboys Revelation song. Y'all listen to it. And I can tell you that when I'm riding in the car sometimes, I reach up and I slide that little slider ball back to the beginning so I can hear the boom, 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 boom. And then when it starts to go into the other music, I slide it back and I listen to that boom, 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 because I want that. I want that. And that just, woo, y'all can see me tearing up now. It's just like I'm going. I'm marching on this day. You're welcome, Renee. You're welcome, Renee and Karen. Yes. Awesome, Lynn. Awesome. Good, Karen. Finished lap one yesterday. Awesome. Awesome. Thank you, Polly. Thank you. Okay. What is going on Planet Shibboleth today? Always good things, right? Always good things. If you're doing the Spartan Elite Challenge, please join Jason this morning for the roundup at 9 a.m. And then Dr. Jim is going to be doing a virtual grocery store tour at 6:30. I've got Fast Track at 7:30. We're going to be going over the food library and a worksheet to start picking out your favorite foods and building meals. And then guess who's doing the How I Overcame Food Addiction and Lost Weight webinar tonight? Travis and Sasha. Now, the reason we have a webinar every single night at 8:30 is so that when you go throughout the day and you see people that you might want to invite to the webinar, you can say, hey, 8:30 tonight. You have got something daily that you can invite them to listen in and see if they would like to join us in the Shibboleth lifestyle, okay? And for my stuff, first class is always free. Invite a friend. Say, hey, you want to see this food library I have access to? Do you want to see this? Invite a friend, okay? And let's make Shibboleth be a household name. Thank y'all for bearing with me today. And I'm gonna go march on the day right now. I'm headed to a networking meeting and then I've got a networking lunch, and we'll go from there. Bye, everybody.